Welcome to the how-to presentation for doing the oscilloscope lab using multisim. So we're going to make a TTL waveform 0 to 5 at 5 kilohertz, and we're going to do some measurements. I'm going to give you a quick tutorial on multisim here so you could do your oscilloscope lab. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to go grab a Tektronix scope. This guy's the same one we use. And I've expanded it. You could use F10 to zoom in, or you could go to view, and there's some other zoom in. So let's grab a couple grounds, and we could go ahead and touch that. If you notice, if you leave that one there. And let's grab a voltage source, clock voltage. That's going to give us our TTL. Close that out. Let's take our... So we could add the wire, or we could just touch it. If it turns red, we got connection. So we got a ground at a ground point. We're on channel one. And we're going to open up our clock. And since we want 5K, and we got 5 volts, 0 to 5, just a TTL, 50% duty cycle. So let's fire it up, open up our scope, turn it on. First thing we do is we adjust our time base way over here. It's good for now. And let's adjust our voltage down to 5 volts per division. All right. And let's go ahead and hit single sequence. That'll lock it in so we could see it. Okay. And let's go ahead and use our trigger menu and adjust the trigger. So now you see the trigger arrow. It's not really necessary. When we've locked it like this, but the trigger arrow is here, so we want the yellow arrow hitting the yellow output waveform. This is our zero, and like the old analog scopes, that doesn't move. This one we can move, take the position, so we can move zero with this scope. Okay, we have our waveform dialed in. Now let's make some measurements. First thing let's do is let's go to measure. And we have different measurements that we could do. Let's go ahead and channel one. And let's, these will go all the way up to 4. So let's go, got channel one. And let's do period, back. Go to the next one down. Let's do channel one again. Let's do positive width, which is the pulse width. Back. Let's go ahead and let's go to negative width. This is the time low. Okay. So we have a positive width of 100 and a negative width of 100. So let's, if you wanted to open that up a little bit, let's see if we could do that. There we go. So we got the same thing, it's, we just got a bigger dial. So let's move this over just a smidgen so we could line it up with our graticles. Close enough. So this moves position across. These positions move up and down. So let's go ahead, now that we've got measurements, let's go ahead and do cursors. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to do time, channel one, and you see the green LEDs come on. So let's find our probes, our cursors. I didn't want that one anyway. There we go. So let's go this one. not super accurate on my on multi-sim, but we're right at 200 microseconds is where we should be. So that is the period. And let's move this guy over. Actually, let's move the other one, so we want to measure positive width. Close enough. Now we're right around 100 microseconds. So let's go back to measure. And if we wanted to calculate the duty cycle, we know it's 50% because we did that, is we are going to take the positive width and divide it by the period. That's going to give us the duty cycle. So 100 divided by 200 is 0.5, multiply it by 100%, and it is a 50% duty cycle. Now let's look at some CMOS waveforms and some duty cycle changes. So let's go ahead and open up our clock, and let's say we want 75%. So we're going to put 75%, which means 75% of the wave is going to be high and 25% of the wave will be low. Still going to stay at 5 volts, and let's stop it, reset it, and let's dial it in. Okay, let's go back to measure. Hopefully we still have our measurements. Yes, we do. And if we look here, channel 1, let's go ahead and do a single sequence. Okay, so channel 1 period, it's 200, and our positive width 150. If I divide 150 by 200 and multiply it by 100%, it's going to be 75% duty cycle. This does not display duty cycle, but we could calculate it here. So we have 75% duty cycle. So let's go ahead and make it a CMOS wave, and let's go to 10 volts. Okay, let's turn it off. Turn it off, back on. And now you see that it's gone up to 10 volts. And that's pretty much it. Everything will be controlled by our clock function. Here's one option on how to do the lab and turn it in. So what we can do is I'm going to give you a Word document. And let's go ahead and let's erase that. And let's go over here and let's use my snipping tool, new. Let's see if I could take this guy, copy it, and paste it into here, and just go ahead and turn in the Word or convert it to a PDF.